Okay, I am back with some more coronavirus prepping. Also, if you're prepping for a flu cold season, this is also a great way to prep for that. I'm starting off with household supplies in this video, so let's get right down to it. Now, this isn't necessarily considered a household supply, but every house should have one, a basic first aid kit. You can easily pick these up just about anywhere. Make sure to have on hand just in case you are quarantined, you do have some basic first aid supplies. I also make sure to have lotion on hand. I know I showed this in my other video, but I do go through a lot of lotion, especially in the winter season. And this bottle will definitely last me for 2 weeks. I actually use my bar soap. You can also have liquid soap. Just make sure you have plenty on hand for a 2 week supply. I actually only use one bar in 2 weeks, so this is overload, or overkill. And then of course, Listerine. Now, I generally will go through as one person a 500 milliliter bottle in 2 weeks. So you can kind of use that as a reference too. Just think about mouthwash is really beneficial to have on hand, because even if you're sick and you have a respiratory virus, you want to have as clean a mouth, and Listerine with the alcohol in it and so forth, you can just swish it around your mouth when your mouth feels yucky, and that actually does help too. So make sure you have, and I like to use alcohol-based mouthwash. I know a lot of people don't like the sting of alcohol, but I really gravitate towards the alcohol antiseptic one during cold and flu season. Shampoo and conditioner. I will use one bottle of shampoo in a 2 week period. Conditioner that lasts like a month. So make sure you have plenty on hand for your family. I also use facial wash. You can also maybe use like wipes of some sort. Make sure that you have your facial lotions and stuff. And then deodorant, that small tube of toothpaste, that usually lasts me 2 weeks. And then I had a couple of toothbrushes. Why I recommend that is when you are sick, you should throw the toothbrush out. And this is recommended by the CDC. Throw the toothbrush out after you've been sick and get a new one. I know you can disinfect toothbrushes, that's great, but they really do recommend that you replace them. So I just have a couple on hand, just in case. Distilled water. Now, again, it's winter, very dry, and I use about 3 gallons of distilled water per week in my humidifier. So think about all the devices that you use when you're sick and how much distilled water you need to use for them. If you use like a vaporizer, humidifier, some other kind of device, and stock up on the distilled water now. Also for eating, dining, what have you, if you're sick, you probably aren't going to want to be doing dishes, and disposable is easy. I know it's not environmentally friendly, but it is easy to just throw instead of worry about disinfecting. Now, 2 week supply, 3 meals a day, that's going to equal 42 cups, 42 plates, 42 bowls, 42 napkins, and 42 knives, spoons, and forks per person. I don't have that, as you can see in front of me. I'd have to have like 2 packages of cups just for me. But again, when I'm sick, I use these items. If I'm not and I'm just quarantined in my house, I will be using my regular dishes and washing and sanitizing them. So I just recommend having bowls, plates, cups. I use Viva pop-ups instead of napkins. Just have them on hand just in case. They're very easy to grab and dispose of. As for dishwashing, make sure that you have plenty of dish liquid on hand. This bottle will definitely last me for 2 weeks. These actually last me quite a long time, and this is a 1.35 pint bottle. So not a very large bottle, but a good one to have on hand. I do run my dishwasher about once a day. So for a 14-week supply, we need 14 of, I like to use these packs by Finish or Cascade. They do come in a 14-pack bag. I happen to get the 23 count because that was the one that was on clearance this past weekend at Dollar General. But make sure that you have a 2-week supply of hand washing detergent and or dish detergent for your dishwasher. Toilet paper. This is like a big thing that runs out of the store fast and a lot of people stock up on. I did some research and the average person will use between 2 to 3 rolls of toilet paper, or I should say 1 to 3 rolls of toilet paper per week per person. Now that's a lot of toilet paper. So this 6 count should last me for 2 weeks. When you're sick, you're probably going to be using the bathroom more. Some people use this as facial tissue. So 6 rolls per person should get you through a coronavirus outbreak. All right. Facial tissues, by the way, I had to look this one up too. And the average, according to the Consumer Index, a person will use 10 tissues per day. So, 1 person, 2 week supply, that would be 140 tissues. Because my box only has 110, I got 2. That should last me through 2 weeks, for sure. Laundry detergent. Generally, I do a load of laundry per day. I just do that to keep up with things. Now, you might be doing extra loads if somebody is sick. This is a 25-load laundry detergent bottle. So definitely a 2-week supply for me. When it says loads, you're using the very minimal amount of laundry detergent. However, if you are adding bleach, or I've showed in another video, I have a Lysol additive, that's a sanitizing additive, you don't necessarily have to use that much detergent when you're putting those additives in there. So you should be good with a small bottle of detergent for 2 weeks. And then one thing that I almost overlooked was trash bags, and they're actually very, very important when you have somebody who's sick in your family. You're gonna wanna take the garbage out once a day, just to make sure that you're removing all that contaminated stuff out of your house, the dirty Kleenexes, the dirty paper plates, cups, etc. So make sure that you have at least a 14-day supply. Obviously, when you have 80 trash bags, that is an overkill again, but so make sure that you do have those on hand, preferably smaller ones to keep next to a bed if somebody is sick, and then also the larger ones you can use in the kitchen. If you can think of anything that I'm missing, please leave a comment below. Otherwise, thanks for watching, everyone. Bye.